we'll see how to find the Fourier transform of the given function. Okay, up till now we have taken the three types of definition. I just recall that definitions. F of lambda is equal to 1 upon square root of 2 pi integral minus infinity to infinity f of u e raised to minus I lambda u du. This we call as a general Fourier transform. Then f of x is equal to 1 upon square root of 2 pi integral minus infinity to infinity f of lambda e raised to I lambda x d lambda. This we call as a inverse Fourier transform, or also called as a Fourier integral representation. Then we saw the Fourier cosine transform, fc lambda. It is square root of 2 by pi integral 0 to infinity f of u cos lambda u du, and inverse of that is given by f of x is equal to square root of 2 by pi integral 0 to infinity fc lambda cos lambda x d lambda. And fs lambda, Fourier sine transform, it is given by square root of 2 by pi integral 0 to infinity f of u sine lambda u du, and inverse of that is given by f of x is equal to square root of 2 by pi integral 0 to infinity fs lambda sine lambda x d lambda. Okay, so we have these three types of formulas in Fourier transform. Okay, firstly, first formula was the general formula, which we use, which we can use it for any function. Okay, this first formula can be used for any function. We use Fourier cosine transform. Okay, we use this formula whenever it is not mentioned and the given function is even function. Okay, for even function generally we go for Fourier cosine transform, and this is corresponding inverse Fourier cosine transform. And if the function is odd, okay, that time generally go for the Fourier sine transform, and this is inverse Fourier sine transform, or it is also called as a Fourier integral representation. In previous lecture, we saw how to use a Fourier integral representation to show integration is equal to some function. So making use of the proper Fourier transform, we can prove such type of terms. Now in this lecture, we'll see if any function is given, then how to find its Fourier transform. Okay. So we'll take a problem, and in all the problems we just use these three types of formulas: general, then Fourier cosine transforms and inverse, and Fourier sine and its inverse transform. So all this unit, all this chapter from this unit depends on these three types of formula: general, cosine and sine formulas. Okay, by properly solving the integration we can get the solution. So carefully remember these formulas. Consider the problems based on it. Find Fourier transform of f of x is equal to k for mod x less than 1, 0 for mod x greater than 1. Again, in the first lecture we saw that if we want to find a Fourier integral representation, but in that if it is not mentioned sine or cosine, then we check for even and odd. The same thing we have to do for this type of problem also. So whenever we want to find a Fourier transform, but if it is not mentioned sine or cosine, then in that case check whether this function f of x is even or odd. If it is even, use corresponding cosine transform. If it is odd, then use sine transform. And in this problem also it is not mentioned sine or cosine, so check for even and odd. Wherever x is there, replace it by minus x. Okay, and then if you get the original function again, then it will be even function, and if you get minus of original, then it will be odd function. So replace x by minus x in everywhere in this function. So f of minus x will be k is a constant, so it will remain as it is. 0 is also constant, so it will remain as it is. Mod of minus x less than 1, mod of minus x greater than 1. Now we know the property that mod of minus x and mod of x, okay, both are same. Okay, mod of both the terms, mod of minus x and x are same. So because of that, mod of minus x is same as mod x, which is less than 1, and same thing for this term also. So what we get, it is equal to k, because these constant terms are there, so it will remain as it is. This will be mod x less than 1 and mod x greater than 1. And just check whether it is same as original or not. And you can see that for mod x less than 1, it takes value k. Same thing over here. Greater than 1, it takes value 0. So same we have for this term also. So this is same as f of x, original function. And if f of minus x is same as original function, then such function we call as a even function. So this is an even function. And whenever the function is even, we use Fourier cosine transform. Okay, so use the formula of Fourier cosine transform. Fc lambda is equal to 2 by 5 integral 0 to infinity f of u cos lambda u du. Okay, now the integration is from 0 to infinity and it is of this function f of u, but the function is defined in different interval. F of x takes value k for mod x less than 1 and 0 for mod x greater than 1. So according to these intervals, we have to split this integration. And this is only for positive intervals. So consider the positive values of x. Less than 1 means we can take the value from 0 up to 1. Between 0 to 1, it takes value k. Greater than 1 means we can take the value from 1 to infinity. Upper limit is not there, so we can go up to infinity. So split this integration into two parts, that is from 0 to 1 and 1 to infinity. Okay, so the integration becomes square root of 2 by pi as it is, integral 0 to 1. Between 0 to 1, the value of the function is k. K is a constant, so it will remain as it is, into cos lambda u plus integral 1 to infinity. Between 1 to infinity, function takes value 0 into cos lambda u du. But 0 into cos will be 0, and integration of 0 is 0. So all this term is equal to 0. Okay. Now just solve this integration. K is a constant. We can take it outside of integral. Integration of cos, we know it is just sine term. So solve this integration, taking k outside, root 2 by pi as it is, and integration of cos is nothing but sine lambda u divided by derivative of lambda u with respect to u. And derivative of lambda u with respect to u is lambda, because lambda is a constant term. Okay, limits from 0 to 1. Now substitute limits. At upper limit 1, we are substituting limits for u. So substitute u equal to 1. So you get sine lambda upon lambda minus sine 0 into lambda, that is sine 0 upon lambda. Sine 0 is 0. So fc lambda is equal to k into square root of 2 by pi sine lambda by lambda. So this is the Fourier transform. This is the answer. Here it is not asked the Fourier integral representation. If it is asked Fourier integral representation, then we also find f of x. But in this problem, it is just asked the Fourier transform. So this is the Fourier transform. Okay. So carefully remember, when it is not mentioned which transform, whether it is cosine or sine, then in that case, check whether the function is even or odd. Even, use cosine transform, odd, use sine transform. Okay. Now consider the next problem. Find Fourier sine transform of e raised to minus ax upon x, and hence evaluate integral 0 to infinity tan inverse of x by a into sine x dx. Okay. Now in this problem, it is already asked to find Fourier sine transform. already mentioned. So don't check for even and odd. If sign is not mentioned, then we check for even and odd. But already in the problem, it is mentioned that find Fourier sine transform. So just take this function as f of x. Take all this function as f of x and use the formula of fc lambda. Okay, use the standard formula of fs lambda and then solve that integration. Okay, so taking f of x as e raised to minus ax by x. Okay, so fs lambda, because sine transform is asked, so directly use the formula. Fs lambda is equal to square root of 2 by pi integral 0 to infinity f of u sine lambda u du. Now you can see that for this function there is no restriction on x. There are no limitations for x term. X can take any value. So directly we can put the value of the function. No need to split the integration. Okay, because this is defined for all x. No limitations for x. If there are limitations for x, then we have to split the integration according to that intervals. But here there are no intervals. So whatever integration is there, you take that integration. Just instead of x terms, take u term. So replace x by u. So it become e raised to minus au divided by u into sine lambda u. Integration of that. Okay. So fs lambda is square root of 2 by pi integral 0 to infinity e raised to minus au divided by u into sine lambda u du. Okay, now we have to solve this integration. Okay, now you can see that there are three terms, e raised to minus au, then sine lambda u divided by u. Okay, if you are having two terms, then we can use integration by parts. Okay, but there are three terms and derivative of no term get vanish. Okay, this is u means it is 1 by u. Integration of 1 by u will not vanish. Derivative of e raised to minus au will not vanish. Integration of sine will also not vanish. So if derivative of any term get vanish, we use integration by parts. But here derivative of no term is vanishing. So using integration by parts is also not convenient. Okay, no standard formula for integration of product of three terms is there. Okay, so solving this integration, you can see it is quite difficult. Directly solving is difficult. Okay, no standard formula, no integration by parts, no other simplification we can do, because converting sine into e raised to term, then we get e raised to this divided by u, again it become complicated. Converting this into sine and cos is also not convenient, because if having e raised to I theta, we use Euler's formula, but here there is no
sir.
Yes
sir, we can use that e raised to x formula,
but for that we are having the formula for this e raised to ax into sine
dx,
but divided by u is there. Here we are having divided by u, one more extra term is there. Only for this we know the formula. If
yes, sir.
Derivative of this term get vanish, if derivative of u 1 by u get vanish, then we take this as u and this as v, because integration of this is known. But derivative of this is not vanishing, because next derivative is minus 1 by u square, next will be minus 2 by u cube, minus 1 by 2 u cube, like that derivative is not vanishing. Okay, so if derivative of any term get vanish, then we go for integration by parts. Integration of this term is known, but that will not be useful because this 1 by u is also there. Okay, so already in M2 we learn one method in which if the integration is quite difficult to solve, and other than this variable, if we have some arbitrary constants, then it can be solved by using DUIS, differentiation under integral sign. Okay, and how to use that DUIS? You can consider all this integration as a function of this A or function of lambda. Consider all this integration as a function of A or lambda. But this is already a function of lambda, so you can take this as it is. So making use of that DUIS rule one, why to use rule one? Because if these limits are constants, then we use rule one. And if these limits are functions of these arbitrary constant, then we use rule two. And what we do in that rule, we take derivative of this term. Find the derivative of this with respect to lambda. And in that case, we find a partial derivative of all this inside term with respect to lambda. So by using DUIS rule, d by d lambda of fs lambda is equal to square root of 2 by pi integral 0 to infinity partial derivative of this with respect to lambda du. Okay, we are taking differentiation under this integral sign. Okay, this rule, DUIS rule. Okay, so when to use? Whenever integration is difficult to solve, other than this u variable, if we have some arbitrary constants, then consider that integration as a function of that term. So here you can take this as a function of a or function of lambda, anything you can consider. But already this is a function of lambda, so directly use the rule. Take a derivative, ordinary derivative here, and here take the partial derivative. Now we are taking partial derivative with respect to lambda. So other than lambda, whatever terms are there, we treat it as a constant term. So e raised to minus au is a constant term. U is a constant term. So only derivative of this term will come. And derivative of sine lambda u with respect to lambda will be cos lambda u into derivative of lambda u with respect to lambda. That will be u. So by using DUIS rule, finding the partial derivative. So partial derivative comes out to be, with respect to lambda, this term is a constant term. Derivative of sine lambda u with respect to lambda is u cos lambda u, because u will be constant with respect to lambda. Okay. Now this u get cancelled with this u, and we know the formula for e raised to ax cos bx. Instead of x, we have u. Instead of a, we have minus a. And instead of b, we have lambda. So use the standard formula. Integral of e raised to ax cos bx, and the formula is e raised to x upon a square plus b square, a cos bx plus b sin bx. So make use of that formula. So using that formula, we get integral e raised to minus au upon minus a square plus lambda square minus a into cos lambda u plus lambda into sin lambda u. This is in the standard formula. Instead of a and b, take minus a and lambda. Okay, so we are using this standard formula here for this term. Okay, this will be a and this will be b, and instead of x we have u term. Now substitute limits, substitute infinity. How much is e raised to minus infinity? E raised to minus infinity is 0. Okay, e raised to minus infinity is 0. How much is cos or sine infinity? Sine or cos infinity. Now we know that sine and cos, these always lies between 1 and minus 1. Okay, values of sine and cos are always between 1 and minus 1. Okay, it cannot be below minus 1, it cannot be more than 1. Okay, so it, so you take any angle, either negative, plus infinity or minus infinity, it will be always a finite value. It is always between minus 1 and 1. So sine and cos infinity, that are finite value, and finite into this 0 will be 0. 0 into infinity is an indeterminate form, but e raised to minus infinity is 0, and sine and cos infinity is a finite term. So because of that, at upper limit, we get 0. At lower limit, 0. E raised to 0, 1, cos 0, 1, sin 0, 0. Okay, so this term will get cancelled. So that gives us dfs lambda upon d lambda is equal to square root of 2 by pi, upper limit 0, minus, at lower limit we get 1 into minus a into 1 divided by this, minus minus, it becomes plus a upon a square plus lambda square. Okay, but our aim is to get the Fourier transform. We want this term, fs lambda. So we have to remove this derivative. Okay, so to get rid of this derivative, you take integration on both sides. Okay, to remove this derivative, okay, you can take integration on both sides. By integration, this derivative can be removed. Now it is the integration of a upon a square plus lambda square. Now we know the integration of x square plus a square is tan inverse. So same thing over here, integration of this term will be tan inverse of lambda by a plus integrating constant. So by taking integration on both sides, fs lambda is equal to square root of 2 by pi tan inverse of lambda by a plus c. Okay, because of this a, 1 by a will not come. Otherwise, 1 upon x square plus a square is 1 by a tan inverse of x by a. But that 1 by a and this a get cancelled. So only tan inverse of lambda by plus c. So we got the Fourier transform. But what happened here? We get one extra constant term. So we have to remove this constant term, arbitrary constant, integrating constant. How to remove this? By doing some proper substitution, by substituting some value for this lambda term, we can remove this c. So what is the value for which tan inverse also we can find, and value of fs lambda also we can get easily. Okay, we know the value of tan inverse of 0, because tan 0 is 0, so tan inverse of 0 is 0. So if you put lambda equal to 0, then what happened? Fs 0. Okay, we get fs 0 is equal to square root of 2 by pi tan inverse of 0 plus c. So tan inverse of 0 is 0, 0 plus c is c into square root of 2 by pi. So it comes out to be c into square root of 2 by pi. And what is fs 0? Fs 0 is nothing but, you know what is fs? Okay. Fs is, this is fs lambda. So in that, if you put lambda equal to 0, in this equation, if you put lambda equal to 0, then what happened here? We get sine 0. Sine 0 is 0. So all this integration becomes 0. So fs 0 will be 0. Okay. So putting that value, we get this value as 0. So what will be c? C will be 0. And put that value back to the equation, that gives us fs lambda is equal to square root of 2 by pi tan inverse of lambda by a. So this is a Fourier transform, Fourier sine transform. Okay, so that is what it is asked to find. Now there is one more part. It is asked to evaluate integration, and we know that we can get integration by making use of inverse Fourier transform. Okay, now here we have fs lambda Fourier sine transform. So take its inverse sine transform. Use the formula of f of x in terms of fs lambda. In that, by that, we can get the terms in the integration. And then we compare with the required integration to get the value of the integration. So use the inverse Fourier transform. Inverse Fourier transform is f of x is equal to square root of 2 by pi, integral 0 to infinity, fs lambda, sine lambda x, d lambda. Substitute fs lambda into it. Value of fs lambda is square root of 2 by pi tan inverse of lambda by a. We are just putting the value, this value, whichever we got just now. Now if you want, you can simplify it. You can take 2 by pi outside, square root of 2 by pi, square root of 2 by pi, it becomes 2 by pi. Taking that 2 by pi to other side, it becomes pi by 2. So it becomes pi by 2 f of x is equal to integral 0 to infinity tan inverse of lambda by a sine lambda x d lambda. Now just look at the integral whose value we want to find. And that integral is this. We want to find what is the value of this. Integral 0 to infinity tan inverse of x by a sine x. Compare this integral with this. Now instead of lambda, we want x term. A we want as it is, then instead of sine lambda x, we want only x. And instead of dx, we want instead of d lambda, we want dx. So we have to do some proper substitution so that this integration get converted to this form. So if you put lambda equal to x, then what happened? Here we get x into x, it become x square. But we doesn't want x square. Okay. So what to do? First of all, put this x equal to 1. First of all, put x equal to 1 and then put lambda equal to x. By that, what happened? This become 1. Then if we replace lambda by x, it become x into 1. That will be x. This become x divided by. So first put x equal to 1 and lambda equal to x. What happened? This integration become tan inverse of x by a sine of x into 1 dx. And here we get pi by 2 f of 1. But f of x is given in the problem. Value of f of x is already given in the problem. That is e raised to minus ax divided by x. So you can use that. Replace x by 1. So it becomes pi by 2 into e raised to minus a. Okay, that is the answer, value of the integration. Okay, so if it is asked only Fourier transform, then value up to fs lambda will be the answer. And if it is asked to solve the integration, if it is asked to find the value of the integration, then make use of inverse Fourier transform. Make use of inverse Fourier transform and then simplify it. Okay, in total problem, we just solve one integration. And rest is a simplification. So in all the problems of Fourier, we have to solve only one integration. And rest is a simplification of the term. And in this problem, integration was quite difficult to solve. So we use differentiation under integral sign. We use DUIS rule. Making use of that rule, we can get the Fourier transform. The next problem, find Fourier sine and cosine transform of f of x is equal to e raised to minus ax. Now, in this problem, it is asked to find both Fourier sine and cosine. Okay, so already transforms are mentioned in the problem. So don't check for even or odd. Okay, don't check for it. Only when we have to check even or not, when sine and cos, it is not mentioned. Only Fourier transform if it is asked to find. But here, sine and cosine, both transforms are asked to find. So don't check for even or not. Directly use the formula for Fourier sine transform and directly use the formula Fourier cosine transform. So use the standard formula. Firstly, we find Fourier cosine transform, fc lambda, square root of 2 by pi 0 to infinity f of u cos lambda u du. Now we want f of u. So wherever x is there, replace it by u term. And there is no restriction on x. X can take any value. There is no restriction on x. So we doesn't have to split this integration. We have to keep these limits as it is. We doesn't have to split this integration. We split the integration only when the function is defined in terms of interval. But here function is not defined in any interval. It is defined for all x. So don't split it. Directly substitute this value here. Replace x by u term. So fc lambda is equal to square root of 2 by pi integral 0 to infinity e raised to minus au cos lambda u du. Okay, now this minus a and lambda are constant. So here you can use the formula e raised to ax cos bx, standard formula. Okay, carefully remember both the formulas, sine and cos, because in most of the problems we use these formulas. So make use of this formula. So making use of that standard formula, it is e raised to minus au divided by minus a square plus lambda square minus a into cos lambda u plus lambda into sine lambda u. Okay, here a is, instead of a we have minus a, and instead of b we have lambda. So we get this term. Now substitute upper limit, e raised to minus infinity is 0, e raised to minus infinity is 0, sine and cosine infinity is finite term, finite into 0 is 0, at lower limit 0, e raised to 0, 1, sine 0, 0, cos 0, 1. So substitute it properly, square root of 2 by pi, at upper limit we get 0, at lower limit this will be 1, minus a into 1 plus lambda into 0. So only minus a will remain, divided by minus a square will be a square plus lambda square. Minus minus it becomes plus. So epsilon lambda is root 2 by pi into a upon a square plus lambda square. Okay, so this is the Fourier cosine transform. Okay, here it is not asked Fourier integral representation, only transform is asked. Okay, so this is the answer. If Fourier integral representation is asked, then we have to find f of x also. But here it is not asked that, only transform is asked. So this is the answer. By same way, we can find a Fourier sine transform. Use the formula of fs lambda. Fs lambda is equal to square root of 2 by pi integral 0 to infinity f of u sine lambda u du. Now again, in the function is not defined in any interval. Okay, it is defined for all x. So without splitting the integration, substitute the value of the function. Wherever x is there, replace it by u. So it becomes integral 0 to infinity e raised to minus au sine lambda u du. Now here you can use the formula integration e raised to ax sine vx. Okay, make use of this formula, standard formula. Okay, and the formula is a sine e raised to ax upon a square plus b square a sine bx minus b cos bx. Now here instead of a we have minus a, and instead of b we have lambda. So make the changes accordingly. So it is e raised to minus a u upon minus a square plus lambda square minus a into sine lambda u minus lambda into cos lambda u, limits from 0 to infinity. Now substitute the limits. At infinity, e raised to minus infinity is 0. E raised to sine and cosine infinity is a finite term. Finite into 0 is a 0. At 0, e raised to 0 is 1. Sine 0 is 0. Cos 0 is 1. Okay. So substituting both upper and lower limit, fs lambda is equal to square root of 2 by pi 0 minus, this will be 0 term, this term will be 0 because sine 0 is 0, cos 0 is 1, this is 1, so it is minus lambda into 1, so it is minus of minus lambda upon a square plus lambda square, minus minus it becomes plus, so fs lambda is equal to square root of 2 by pi into lambda upon a square plus lambda square. So this is the Fourier transform. So whenever we have a problem of Fourier transform and it is not mentioned that find Fourier sine transform or cosine transform, that time check for even error. And if it is even, use cosine transform. If it is odd, use sine odd, then use sine transform. Neither even nor odd, use the general Fourier transform. Okay. And if it is mentioned sine or cosine, then don't check for even and odd, as we saw in this problem. Here already it is mentioned sine and cosine both. So we doesn't have to check for even and odd. Okay. And by using that standard formulas, we can easily find a Fourier transform. Okay.